Hi Jacob, welcome to Sporting Stories. Thank you for agreeing to share your story with us.
Yeah, great to be here, man.
So we've just seen a short clip which shows a bit of your sort of transformation and your journey so far. Can you tell us a bit about what was the turning point for you that sort of made you realise there was that need for change in your life?
Well, it was more, I was looking at myself in the mirror over lockdown. I think like a lot of people, I got very overweight. I was always a super skinny kid. You could always see my ribcage through my thing. And especially when you go from super skinny to, I was getting there. And people started to point it out, obviously, because it wasn't. If you've always been a bit chubby, it's less of a, but, oh, last time I seen you, you were super skinny. And now you're a bit chubby. You know, you've got a bit of fat around you. I mean, mainly, you know, lockers, changing rooms, all that stuff, PE. That's where it gets pointed out the most, really. So then I realized, you know, I need a change.
And so small comments sort of got to you and sort of got to your head and made you realize something's not right. Something needs to happen. Something needs to change.
Yeah, 100%. I'm really like susceptible to them kind of comments. I always take them right on. It's never, you know, oh, it's a joke. I always take them right to the head. So I changed.
And were they comments from like your friends who wanted you to make a change, of people that were just taking the mickey, or?
It's just a bit of both. I mean, when your friends say it, it's a bit like, oh, okay. But it's when other people that are just, they genuinely are, because, you know, they're looking at you, they're seeing, and they're saying what they feel. So that was really what got to me, because I know for a fact they're telling the truth.
And so this all occurred during lockdown. During lockdown, did you start training? Was it after lockdown? What was the sort of time scale in all this?
It was after lockdown, because in lockdown, I think like a lot of people, I got very addicted to video games. I was playing Fortnite, Minecraft, all them, Warzone as well. I was playing all the games, and I'd snack as I played. So I was having like 8-10 snacks a day. It was getting ridiculous because I don't realize I'm doing it. I'd reach and I'd eat, and then I just slowly, I guess, got larger.
And so you sort of didn't realize that it was going to have that effect, and you didn't sort of perceive that I was doing all this stuff, it's going to make me really unhealthy? Or did you realize and not care? What was your sort of mindset?
I never realized. It was almost because I was never out and about. I never had, because of lockdown, I never had anyone to point it out. So because no one was pointing it out, I didn't realize it was happening.
So then when you sort of realized this is happening, is that I need to make a change, what was your like first few steps in making that start of that change?
Well, I'm very lucky. My gym takes 14-year-olds and above. I know a lot of gym, you have to be 16.
16 above, yeah.
Yeah, so that was really useful for me. But also my cousin, I have an older cousin. He was very into the gym. I think he still is. He goes a lot. But he was always in and out. You know, you'd go into his house, you'd open the cupboard for a snack, and there'd just be bags of protein and stuff. Yeah, and he's probably the one that actually helped me to start the gym. I remember I got my first kind of like program, like the free ones off Google. You just search free gym program, and he showed me how to do all the exercises with proper form, so I'd actually progress. So kudos to him. That's actually probably the reason I'm here.
That's great. That's great to hear you had someone support you along the way. So of course you had that support, and you had the support of your family also trying to encourage you and friends. Did you find the people at the gym also encourage you, other people you didn't know, like other people just there?
I know for a fact that one thing that's always stuck with me is one day I was squatting. I used to have terrible squat form. I was doing like a high bar. My legs were this close apart. And I used the pads, like the thick pads. And a guy came over, completely random, never met him in my life. And he spent like 5-10 minutes of his training session showing me how to do a squat with proper form, you know, how to get it so it doesn't hurt when I don't use the pad. And ever since, obviously, I've stopped using the pad. It's got a lot better. My training's gone a lot better. So if it wasn't for him, I'd probably still be doing my squats wrong, hurt my knees.
So that's great to hear that people, you know, are there to support you. People that don't know you, people that don't need to support you, they still do. It just shows how welcoming everyone is and supportive everyone is of each other. And I think that's great to hear. And again, that's very repetitive over everyone else's stories, how people, random people have gone and helped them, which is good to show to people you want to start the gym, that people would be there to help you ultimately. And when you went to the gym and you've done all this stuff, it surely hasn't been a straight progression. Surely you've faced some difficulties and challenges along the way.
Oh, yeah, 100%. So at some points, you know, at the start, I was just kind of training, no dietary at all. And obviously, if you're not eating properly, progress is going to slow significantly. So at the start, obviously, you started working out, so you see a lot of improvement. And then because I wasn't getting enough protein, enough calories, it just went slowly down. I got really unmotivated. I was taking rest week after rest week, and I was just saying, oh, I need the rest. But like three rest weeks in a row gets a bit excessive. But yeah, so I got really unmotivated, and then I started researching, and then I started going on TikTok and looking up all these people. And then that's when I found out about protein, about calories, bulking, cutting. I just learned about everything. So yeah, that really helped.
Yeah, learning process for you, and not just in terms of getting yourself from, you know, where you were to where you are now and further. It's more about learning your knowledge and trying to develop some sort of understanding of actually what you're doing and how it's helping you.
Yeah, so each exercise, kind of what muscles it's targeting, what kind of heads each muscle has, you know, really in depth, trying to find out what I'm actually doing to myself and why it's working, so I can help other people to kind of replicate that kind of progress.
And when you mention helping other people, for people that are watching this and don't know, you did share your journey on TikTok and on social media of other people who are trying to do similar to what you've done. And what made you decide to start sharing your journey with other people and sort of vlogging it and sharing videos of it? What was the reason that made you do that?
Well, I've always liked to vlog my special interests. At one point, even before I had my account called Clonks, I had an account called Lamicles. And it that was bigger than Clonks right now. And I did stuff like sweet reviews. And obviously at that time I was eating a lot of food. You can actually, if you go back, I don't think any of the videos are there, but you could see I was getting larger every video. And the thing was, I was doing sweet reviews and I did pretty well. I think that account at its peak has something like 40,000 followers. So that went really well. I've always liked to vlog my interests. So then obviously when gym became my primary interest, you know, thinking about it, dreaming about it, doing it, that was my one goal. It became something I just gradually started videoing.
And did that give you satisfaction when people watching you, you know, were supporting you, but also saying, oh, you've helped me go on to start the gym or go on to make a transformation?
Yeah, so when I get an Instagram DM of someone saying, you've helped me join the gym, how do I join the gym? What things do I need to join the gym? How do I figure out how much protein I need? Just they come to me for questions. Now, obviously, I might not be the most qualified, but they trust me enough to give them that kind of advice that they think and will change their kind of physique, life, mindset. And I feel like if you've got that many people trusting in you, it really improves your self-confidence.
What sort of advice would you give to someone like them who are already started their journey or about to, or just people that are looking to, they can't sort of make themselves do it? What advice would you give to people looking to make a change with their life?
This might sound like the worst advice, but don't deep it. Honestly, just go. You will enjoy yourself. That's the thing as well. I feel like a lot of people think that training is boring. It's very almost labor that they don't want to do. But when you get in there and you have fun, you do enjoy yourself and you enjoy the progress even more. The way you see yourself change is absolutely magnificent. It's incredible. And you will become happier normally. You will have a better mindset. You'll be more motivated to get up in the morning and just do things that will change. Because once you do it and you realize that it works, you keep repeating it. And it's just, it's like dominoes. One gets better than the next, then the next, then the next. No,
It's just the start of getting into the habit of, you know, going to the gym, working in what you're eating, how you're sleeping, how you're drinking, how you're, you know, sort of focusing on yourself and building on yourself and in the right way, because you can do it, but you need to do it in the right way. Otherwise, you're wasting your time. You're not going to make an actual difference. Well, it's great to hear. So thank you very much for sharing a story with us. It's been great. I hope people see this and realize that, I mean, you're only 15 years old, so you're never too young to start. You can start at whatever age, and you know, the earlier you start, the better, because then you've got more time to do it. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more sporting stories.